A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. Wait, no, not that one. In a galaxy filled with geopolitics, religion, feuding races. Wait, no, wrong one again. Yeah, no, I haven't even seen this one. No, the sci-fi franchise I'm talking about is a video game series where a stoic 7-foot superhuman in green armor single-handedly saves humanity and prevents the destruction of the universe while managing to fall in love with a girl on the computer.
He just like me, for real!
And the most underrated game in the franchise doesn't even feature this Chad of a protagonist at all.
Please say hello to the folks that I know. Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song.
Halo 3 ODST, released in 2009, was just 2 years after the first Halo game I ever played, and 1 year before the last Halo game I enjoyed playing. Halo 3 ODST was among the few last Halo games developed by Bungie, the second to last mainline FPS game before the franchise was handed off to 343 Studios. ODST was originally going to be a feature film directed by Peter Jackson. After it fell through, however, Bungie realized it had a small window between Halo 3 and the subsequent launch of Halo Reach. That's when the idea of a mini-campaign came into fruition. Thus, the birth of Halo 3 ODST. With just 14 months of production, Bungie and the ODST development team managed to deliver an experience that was unique to Halo, while remaining true to its roots. A truly special experience. Among the mainline FPS Halo games, this is one of the two games where you don't play as the Master Chief, and one of one games where it doesn't feature the Master Chief or any Spartans, as a matter of fact. Instead, you're playing as an ODST, short for Orbital Drop Shock Troopers, whose job is to drop out of pods from a spaceship onto the planet. Basically, space paratroopers. The job they have, and the name itself, frankly, makes them so cool! And their design is so clean and so slick, it's so badass! Look at it! Appreciate it! It's so cool! And the idea of playing as a non-Spartan is what really creates the atmosphere of ODST. You see, while ODSTs are the top of the cream troopers, they're not Spartans. Because Spartans they're basically demigods. They're humans who have been augmented to become superhuman. We're talking about 7-footers that wear 1,000-pound armor, capable of running up to 70 miles per hour in that armor, and able to lift 3 times their body weight. That's insane! And that is who you play in nearly every Halo FPS game other than ODST and Reach. What makes ODST so special is the fact that you're not this unkillable immortal, but you're human. You're vulnerable. It makes you realize how unstoppable and how powerful the Covenant really were in the face of normal humans. In my opinion, there are two main reasons why ODST shines the way it does, and that's its storytelling and atmosphere it creates. Where the two go hand in hand, the soundtrack in ODST just goes dummy hard. Composed by OGs Martin O'Donnell and Michael Salvatori, who composed all the Halo games, one to Reach, they composed bangers you already know. Bangers like this. While in ODST, they balance between epic battle theme music, which builds up a tense feeling for each firefight you get into, and then throw in a jazzy noir music at night as you try to solve the mystery of what happened to your missing teammates. In my opinion, when it comes to setting a tone and atmosphere in a video game, it all begins with the music. There's no better way to immerse yourself into a game than the music. Persona, Fallout, Breath of the Wild, Minecraft, Final Fantasy XIV, and Pokemon are just a few that come to mind. these games all have a banger of a soundtrack, and all these games have the ability to suck you in and forget about reality for a while. And ODST joins this pantheon of such games. The gameplay of you in the night exploring the war-torn city of New Bombasa truly makes it feel as if you're all alone behind enemy lines. Which goes hand in hand with you not being a Spartan. Each nighttime Covenant patrol you come across is no joke. Compared to other games, you're not the sponge bullet named Master Chief anymore. You're immersed into carefully taking fights and using every advantage you get. Because you can rarely just go in and go guns blazing like previously with Master Chief. Just speaking from experience, I played this game and finished it in the hardest difficulty, and I cannot tell you the amount of times I've died playing against a group of brutes, or two hunters that showed up and nearly gave me a heart attack. You really aren't an indestructible 7-foot god in this game. You're human. And this game really makes you understand that. And that's why ODST is the most underrated game in the Halo franchise. With the release of Halo Infinite recently, it made me reminisce on my past Halo experiences. From split-screening in Halo 3 and seeing where my friends are, to what I believe am the only person to enjoy armor lock in Halo Reach, to ultimately falling off the Halo train after Halo 4. And if I'm being honest with you guys, I never beat the ODST campaign until the makings of this video. I was always scared as a kid, and I only got into like a quarter of the campaign, because it was scary at night. That atmosphere that they created really was something else. But even as a kid, I knew that this game was different from the rest. It was special in a way that was Halo, but not the Halo I was familiar with. So here I am now, as an adolescent, reminiscing on his childhood, here to tell you that Halo 3 ODST is the most underrated game in the franchise. So now I'm telling you, as a fan that grew up with this franchise, that watched its rise and fall to where it is now, that I'm glad I got to experience it as a kid. It's kind of weird seeing big video game franchises now that used to run my childhood turn into such a mediocre mess. It's kind of heart-wrenching. Call of Duty, 2K, Battlefield, these big name AAA games that I would be in the PS4 party playing on hours with my friends, they just don't hit like they used to anymore. I even played a bit of Halo Infinite recently, and it didn't feel like the Halo I was accustomed to. But maybe that's for the better. I'll just end this video off with one of the greatest lines in the entire Halo franchise.
What can I say? It was a hell of a night.